So here's our normal distribution again. I'm going to write it as exp for exponential minus a half x minus mu square over sigma square. And the truth is, when you're new to this, it looks really cryptic. When you're with statistics for many years, as I have been, you wake up in the middle of the night and you can recite this formula. It's as normal as getting breakfast in the morning or having a beer after dinner. What I want to get into your brains is not the complexity of the formula. I want you to really understand how this formula is constructed. I want to understand the quadratic penalty term of deviations from the expectation, from the mean of this expression, and then the exponential that squeezes us back into the bell-shaped curves. That's basically what it is. So we can draw values from this normal distribution just the same way as we flipped coins before. And the way to look at this is any value x has this probability up here. This is nothing else but a notation of the probability of x for a normal distribution with mu and sigma square. So a value x that has twice a higher bar than some other value x prime will have twice as much of a probability of being drawn. Now obviously the normal has an entire continuous space of outcomes, and obviously that renders each individual outcome of probability zero. But in essence, you can think of the height of this thing over here as being proportional to the probability that this value is being drawn.